everybody. So today's video comes by way of Facebook. I got a question from Christopher OK. And I'm like, okay, Christopher, that is the best name ever. I wish my name was Trina. All right. Whoa, I don't know where that came from. Anyway, he asked a question about tallow CLA and ceramides. And because I didn't know a lot about ceramides and I wanted to learn more, I said, I will make that a topic of a video. What is a ceramide? They are a family, a family of waxy lipid molecules. Lipids are fats or oils that are found in the body. They look a little something like this. They consist of a fatty acid linked to a sphingoid base. I love that word. And they are connected by an amide bond. There are at least 9 major ceramides present within the stratum corneum, that is the outermost layer of skin. They have conveniently named them ceramides 1 through 9. Imagine if you had a family and you just named your kids 1 through 9. This reminds me of when I was a kid and my dad wanted to name my twin sisters Alpha and Beta. My mom was like, yeah, no. These ceramides, they differ by their head group, the length of their chain, by the hydroxylation, which is the amount of OH groups they have, and whether they're saturated or not. So that is the number of double bonds. You're probably wondering, where can I find these ceramides? I was certainly wondering that. You can find ceramides in the stratum corneum. Inside, there is these layers of dead skin cells, and sandwiched in between them is this glue. And this glue holds the skin cells together. It is called the interstitial lipid matrix or intercellular cement. These lipids form these ordered structures called lamellar sheets, and they alternate between water and lipids. And that lipid layer is composed of ceramides, cholesterols, and fatty acids. These waxy lipids help us regulate our water holding capacity, allowing a barrier that doesn't easily let fluid penetrate through it. And this is important because we want to maintain optimal water levels in our skin. We also want to make sure that we keep disease-causing microorganisms out. Or, for example, if we come in contact with harmful chemicals, we don't want to get them into our body. Ceramide levels decrease as we get older, so as we age, we start to struggle with dry skin. The outer layer of the stratum corneum starts to decrease, it gets a lot thinner, and we start to notice fine lines. Also, people who struggle with skin disorders like atopic dermatitis, eczema, and psoriasis, those folks seem to have a decreased level of ceramides present in their skin. The idea behind ceramides in skincare is that if we're missing ceramides in our skin, maybe we can just replenish them by adding them into products that we use. And so cosmetic companies have taken this idea and they've run with it. They've put ceramides into hundreds of skincare products that make claims like increases skin hydration, improves the cutaneous barrier, prevents moisture loss, and reduces dry and flaking skin. In our body, they're produced in the stratum granulosum that is below the stratum corneum. They originally appear as phospholipids, and as they work their way up to the stratum corneum, there's these enzymes in the stratum corneum that convert them into ceramides. Nobody is harvesting human bodies to get these ceramides. Instead, we are getting them from other natural and synthetic sources. Synthetics obviously come from a lab. For natural sources, they either come from animal sources such as cows, but they are mostly extracted from plant sources like sweet potatoes, wheat, and brown rice. What I also learned is that ceramides are expensive, which is why we see them in high-end skincare. Natural ceramides are very unstable substances, and because they are costly to obtain, synthetic ceramides are frequently used. Unfortunately, synthetic ceramides do not penetrate the skin as well. Cosmetic companies are looking into technologies like liposomes to help them better penetrate the skin. But I don't know. What do you think? Do you think it works? Do you think it does it? Tell me in the comments. comments. From the studies I've seen so far, it looks like ceramides do moisturize, but I haven't seen any evidence that they moisturize better than some of the inexpensive ingredients that are already out on the market. In some of these studies, they're comparing ceramides to untreated skin, and that hardly seems fair. They're also using higher concentrations of ceramides than you would expect to see in a normal cosmetic product. Christopher, I hope I did an okay job with this video. If you liked this video, give me a thumbs up. If you want to see more like it, consider subscribing. And lastly, don't forget to click that notification bell, especially if you want to leave a comment right when that video drops. I will see you soon. Have a great day.